since it's my first video, I'm gonna do something special, and I'm gonna make my favorite stuffed wontons. Ones with cream cheese, and then ones with ground beef. So for the ground beef ones, it's really, really simple. I'm gonna just do a small one since I'm gonna only make like a pack and a half or so. So you're gonna use about a pound of ground beef, a little bit of soy sauce. Oh, get all this gunk out. Oh. Yes, and I'm doing it with nails on, of course. Luckily, I got a scrubber to scrub off all the stuff. So yeah, for the ground beef ones, you're gonna do about a pound of ground beef. If you like the ground beef ones more, you can do more than that. Or like how my parents used to do it, is they would substitute the ground beef for ground turkey, which would still taste the same. Since I'm only using a pound, I'm using like about a half a pack of Ritz crackers that I've already smashed up. I'm also using about 1/4 cup of chopped up onions. And then I'm also using about 1 carrot shredded. The great thing about a shredded is that all you gotta do is just shred it with a cheese grater and it comes out perfect. So then drizzle about a good maybe like tablespoon, maybe 2 of soy sauce. And somebody wants to finally wake up. A little bit. A couple shakes of some red pepper. 1 good drizzle of this. And just because I like to give it an extra kick, a little teeny drizzle of some chili oil. Except for mine's spicy sriracha. And 1 egg.
So I put the egg, mixed it around, and I forgot to also say that to put a little bit of salt, maybe about a half a teaspoon or so, just a little bit, just because it'll bring out the flavor more. So I'm gonna put that aside. And for the cream cheese ones, super, super easy, so most of the same ingredients. So about 1 pack of cream cheese, which I already dumped in there. About a half a bushel. So with the green onions, just chop up about half of that bun and put it in there. Again, sprinkle just a 1 quick little thing of the pepper. A good squeeze of the horchan sauce. I can't even pronounce this right. And because I like to add different shit and it tastes really good, is some cooked shrimp. I know you can hear me eating it though. So I used about 10 large shrimp. You can use more or less if you like with the shrimp. When I was always taught growing up, because this is, yeah, my family was taught like this, was we always just used the regular crab meat, which you're about to use, the 1 pack. But I added it with the shrimp and it tastes so good. You don't usually get that whenever you go get it at Chinese restaurant. And mostly you usually do is they just put the cream cheese and the green onions in it. Sometimes with the crab meat, not always, but you never really see it with the meat, unless if you're getting like a wonton soup or something. But still, it's so good. Mainly, most of the time it's supposed to be an appetizer, but in my family, we eat it as like an entree. just because it's so good and it's so filling. Usually with about this amount of the cream cheese and the ground beef, I get, sometimes I get extra just because I don't know if I always get over. I usually go over sometimes. 1 pack of wonton wraps. Make sure it's the wonton ones because it's the smaller, and I'll show you how we're going to wrap them up later. Just because if you get the egg roll ones, it's going to be way too big. But I mean, you can still use what's perfect. Is the ground beef ones. Okay. If you add maybe a couple little extra ingredients, you'll make some perfect egg rolls. But the wonton wraps is what's perfect. And they're so cheap. I mean, at Winko, they're like a dollar something. At Walmart, I believe they're a dollar something. Sometimes the price goes up, but at Walmart, it's like $2. I don't know anywhere else you can get them. I do know Raley's and Bel-Air sells them. They sell them kind of pricey, but I mean, if you're on that Raley's and Bel-Air or North Hills food program or reward program, like me, sometimes that stuff will get like a little bit cheaper. So yeah, I'm gonna just break up some of this to make it easier because it's a pain and doesn't really break up when you're gonna break it up with a fork. Good thing me, I have 2 different size forks for my fork set, so mine's really big, so I can use it as like kind of like a crusher to break up this more, just because of the all the stuff I'm putting in. You could use probably real crab meat. I don't know how that would taste. I've never tried it with real crab meat. Just because real crab meat is expensive and probably a pain to get, and then you know you gotta get the out of the crab legs and everything. So this is actually a lot cheaper. It's only like $2. Well, actually, that one costs only like $1 something, but still, it's a lot cheaper. And I don't even remember if I put soy sauce in here. So yeah, you always want to put soy sauce in here, just to kind of give it, like, anytime you're cooking something, if it's super dry, it's like super hard to mix up. So that's why you kind of want to put the liquid in there, just so that way it gives it a little bit more flavor and it makes it way easier to break up. So yeah, I'm going to mix this and I will be right back.
I already have them kind of set up to do it, but I also kind of forgot to. Sorry about all this. It's my first time, so, yeah. The cream cheese ones, if you're only going to do either shrimp or the crab meat, just do one pack. If you're going to do both, I would recommend to do two, just so that way it comes out kind of more creamy. Otherwise, it's going to be not as creamy. But, yeah. So, what you're going to do is want to break out the wraps. You'll notice that some of them are kind of stuck together, so you want to make sure you break them out evenly. And either use maybe sometimes, I would just say like a big spoon, which should be about a tablespoon, to evenly distribute out your filler. So the way I do it for the cream cheese ones is really simple. So to seal them all up, what you need is just a small bowl of water. And just dip your finger and just make a good, nice L shape. So that way one side is wet and one side is dry. And then just go over. Try to make it like as much as you can see it. You just go over and press the dry side onto the wet side. So that way you make a nice little triangle. You want to make sure that there's no like empty gaps or bubbles out, just because then the oil, when you're frying them, is going to seep on through. So then you can do that. You can even crunch it up like how you see it at some places. So it's like that. Now for the meat ones, still pretty simple. Get your finger wet, put one side onto the meat, get the other end wet, bring the dry side, the top of the dry side, get that wet, bring one end over, and then bring it over again. So that way it's like a square. I mean, you can do them in different shapes. The reason why I make them in two different shapes is just so I know which one's meat and which one's the cream cheese one. I mean, when you go to most Chinese restaurants, they'll have them like all up more. But I mean, there's some places where you'll still see them as like the triangle. I know the place in Natomas that I always used to go to, they do them in triangle form, and they do them with both the cream cheese of the crab meat. So I mean, like, everyone that I know of loves the cream cheese ones, but I mean, they're kind of expensive when you go get them. I know the place here that sells up really, really good, but they make them more fatter, but still kind of small. They charge you about $6, and you only get maybe about like 5 of them. Still, like, you get a lot more, and all of this is maybe like at most $10, and you get way more than that. Just because, I mean, your green onions are less than $1. Your cream cheese, if you want to be like me and just buy the regular generic brand, it's, again, less than $1. The only thing that's just going to be kind of pricey is your sauces. If you want to have, like, soy sauce, sweet and sour sauce, you know, some type of spicy chili sauce, and then obviously your crab meat. And then your wonton wraps. But your wonton wraps is only going to be no more than $3. I mean, I've never seen it anywhere else more than $3. Even at Bel Air, they only charge you like $2 something. Still, It's not that bad. You can make these as appetizers for a little party. You can make this, you know, whenever you want to make Chinese food, just make a couple of them or so. You can leave the fillers. You can bag them up, make sure that they're good and sealed up. And I want to say the meat would probably last another day or so, another day or two, if you wanted to wait on that. If you buy it fresh, you could actually freeze it, and then it'll be good for a little bit longer, too. Versus the cream cheese will probably last you maybe, like, a good week. Because I know I always, as you can see, I make a lot of the cream cheese more than the meat ones, just because those ones are my favorite. Those ones are usually a lot of everyone's favorite. Even my daughter, who's only one, actually likes the cream cheese ones. She will actually eat these. My niece, who is going to be 10 later on this year, she only likes the meat ones. She sometimes actually doesn't even want to eat wontons. She's not a big seafood fan. She's more of a meat lover. But still, this is like a really good thing. It's not super expensive. You can get fun and creative and make different shapes with all of them. You don't have to make just the meat ones or just the cream cheese ones. It's all up to you. Getting more of this done, actually, what you need to start doing, so if you don't have a wok, you can use like a Dutch oven or just like a really good deep pan to put oil, because you're going to be like deep frying it, or if you have a deep fryer, perfect. So with the wok, you don't want to put like hella oil, just because it is going to splash back. So I only put maybe about like a half a pot's worth. Maybe sometimes a little less, just because once I put the actual wontons in there, it is going to go up. So while that is heating up, which I do have on high right now, I'm going to finish up wrapping up these. So that way this will be all ready. So as you can see, I already probably started cooking a little bit of them. But once it gets kind of hot, if you don't have a wooden stick or like a wooden spoon, sorry, stick. Best way to just do is to just put one of them in there and see if it starts bubbling up super. If it doesn't, then it's not hot all the way. Once it gets super hot, you kind of want to turn it down after a while. But, so the cream cheese ones, they usually don't take that long, just because since everything in them is pretty much cooked. The meat ones, they do take an extra minute just because you're cooking them. If when you're wrapping up, you kind of get them a little bit flat. It makes it a lot faster to cook, because if it's in like a meatball type of shape, it does take a little bit longer. But you want to have it on like about a medium heat, just so you're not burning them. But you don't want them super light, so that way they don't kind of do this, where they're just so light. You want them more coming out like a little bit darker like that. Best thing to use is a spider or a regular like slotted spoon, but if you're frying, don't use a plastic one, just because it will like burn up and bubble. So once you start seeing them get a little bit more tan, especially if you don't have like me, I don't really put a whole lot of oil, just because I want to be able to flip them. So if you don't put a whole lot of oil, you do need to flip them halfway through. Otherwise, if you have a deep fryer, you don't need to worry about that. Yep. I mean, relatively, they only got to be in there for maybe about 2 minutes or so, just until you see that nice good brown. And then put them in another pan or like a plate with a paper towel, just so that way they can kind of drain off. I really wouldn't recommend using a tong, just because they might break. I mean, if you want to use them, that's canny. It's a lot easier when you are using this, just because you're getting all that oil off of it. Yeah. Especially once you have it like a nice good, like darker tan. For the meat ones, when you're setting them off to the side, they're gonna kind of cook a little bit more, so that's why you don't want to have them overcook, or it's just kind of rough and hard. But you don't want the undercook where you'll see that red and the pink mess. But other than that, that's how you do them. Just plop a couple in there a few times. There we go. So yeah, you'll have something like that. Yeah. So yeah, hit the like button, subscribe, and maybe I'll do another one again. Bye.